If you're on an old and filthy laptop and you are getting terrible FPS, or your PC has simply broke down and you want to play the latest Call of Duty Warzone, which is actually free for the Battle Royale, which is what we're going to be playing in today's video, then you've come to the right video because we've got 6 cores, 12 threads of the Ryzen 5 1600 AF. It's pretty much the same CPU as the Ryzen 5 2600, only it's coming in at $85, which is a really good deal in my opinion. Though, for the cooler, we're gonna be saving money and just using the included stock cooler with this CPU. And then for the motherboard, we're going with a budget B450M motherboard. This one here is a Gigabyte Gaming. I just found the cheapest motherboard I could find on eBay and selected it. And I was lucky because it's got a nice red and black aesthetic, which is going to go well in today's build. Now, if you do want to overclock your Ryzen CPU or you want to upgrade to more cores, more threads in the future, you may wish to invest a little bit more on a motherboard. But for what it's worth, this one right here will do an absolutely fine job for today's build. For the graphics card though, we're going with a GTX 1070. This is a used one. I picked this up for under $200. And the thing about this card is it's got 8 GB of VRAM and it's still very quick by today's standards. If you want to go with a new graphics card, you might want to consider something like a 1660 Super or a 5600 XT from AMD. Though for the memory, we've got 16 GB of Vengeance Pro RGB memory from Corsair. Again, I picked this up on a sale. You don't have to go with this stuff, but it's going to look definitely fancy on this motherboard right here. And then to power this whole build, we're using a Cooler Master MWE 450W. And you may be thinking, whoa, 450W, that's not enough juice for today's build. Believe it or not, I actually tested this power supply in a video, I'll put the link up here, with a 3950X 16 core and a RTX 2080 Ti. That's right, the best on both fronts for gaming PCs. And this thing held up absolutely fine. It's also got all black sleeve cabling and it's a really good value for money power supply at the moment. Though for drives, we've got a 240 GB SSD, 1 TB hard drive, and then the last element is the RGB case. This is a tempered glass TG303. It even includes the remote control so you can change the RGB to make your PC go faster on the fly. Though speaking of RGB and making things go fast, with the jokes aside, we've got a PC that's coming in over the recommended specs, where they're recommending a GTX 970 or better. And then on the CPU side, they've got a Ryzen 5 1600X, which in this case, like we said before, this is more like a 2600, so it's actually better in performance. And then on the CPU side for Intel, they've got a 2500K, which is nowhere near similar in performance to a Ryzen 5 1600X. Anyway, I'm not sure what's going on there, but weirdness aside, we've got one fast AF PC to put together and then run some Battle Royale through it. So let's get on with it. Thank you. And now we're at the finished product, and there is a few things to do before we boot into Call of Duty Modern Warfare. And it has to do mainly with the memory right here and getting that to its XMP profiles. This is gonna give you a big performance uplift on Ryzen systems. So in order to do this, when you start your computer, you just hit the Dell or F2 key, and then in the BIOS, there should be the option to load XMP profile. We just hit enter, put this in, and then we go to save and exit changes. Now with the CPU, I tried overclocking it a little bit, but I found since we're using the included cooler, I tried to get this up to 3.8 gigahertz all core, and the problem is that it started overheating on the cooler. Now the good thing about this CPU out of the box is it runs 3.5 gigahertz all cores, but it also boosts up to 3.7 gigahertz, or at least that's what I'm seeing here in my tests. So basically, the only thing you need to do to get this running really smooth out of the box is load those XMP profiles, and of course, have an RGB remote. If you change this to red, you should also get some more performance as well. Though the last thing before we jump into the games is, since we're using a brand new motherboard, we're getting that annoying Windows needs activation message in the bottom right hand corner. So the easiest way to get rid of this is to use today's video sponsor in the description below. By clicking that link, you can get a Windows 10 Pro license for as little as $15 when you use the coupon code TYCSK on checkout. It's easy to do. Grab that code, whack it in, click activate, and you're good to go. And playing Warzone ended up being a mix of absolutely love it, and then on the other side, absolutely frustrating to get this game to work properly. I've never seen so many errors upon installing a new game in my life. And so what I did was I kept getting these dev errors, and then I had to go in, open as administrator in the settings, apply it to both the .exe files in the folder. But then after that, it sort of half worked, and it kept dropping out and giving me errors. And then after that, I decided to update my BIOS, and finally it started working. At least like probably two in every three games would work properly. Sometimes I'd still drop out. And in fact, there was this weird thing where my graphics card didn't even, not even overclocked. My graphics card was fine. The temperatures were fine, everything was fine. It would just start displaying weird textures. So that when they say this game is still in beta, they really mean it's still in beta. So if you come into any problems, you're most likely just going to have to wait for an update, for the game itself to update, or update the drivers. So I did also, on top of that, reinstall my drivers completely after I did the BIOS update. So things seem to be working okay, but after finally working out all the problems and getting into the game, they've really done something different with this Battle Royale. I absolutely love it. And it's like got squad mode where you got two other teammates and you can res each other. But even if you drop off, you can then have a chance to get back into the game. So the mechanics of the game automatically in that feat are really good. The circle also closes in a bit faster, I believe, than other games. So it does get to conclusion time a lot faster, which I personally enjoy. And then they've got all the loadouts and mechanics of the game, which I am really digging so far. I think it's a lot better in the mechanics of the game than the previous Call of Duty Battle Royale that they released. This one feels really polished besides all the problems. So hopefully they can iron that out in the next couple of weeks, and they're gonna have a really popular Battle Royale on their hands. I think over 6 million people have downloaded this game already in the first 24 hours. So it is very popular, despite it being a whopping 175 gigabyte download. Absolutely huge. I'd like to see them maybe just make a condensed version for the Battle Royale, because if I'm benchmarking this thing and I got to re-download the game every single time on different computers, that 175 gigabyte limit on my Australian internet is going to get tiring very quickly. But let's talk about FPS and this game. If you can't get anything to work and it only works in safe mode for now, that might be an option you have to go with. So initially we were getting around 160 average FPS, 1% and 0.1% lows were really smooth. But keep in mind, in this mode, you'll be limited to 720p and you can't change any of the graphics settings. But when you reboot the game, if you want to go into 1080p and do a mix of settings, which I'll show you guys on the screen what settings I'm using, you can get some really smooth FPS and pretty much no dips, but also still a good visual experience. I like to leave textures and some other settings on high, but then turn down volumetric lighting and stuff that can cause stuttering and things that really aren't going to help you spot the enemy. I will say one thing about safe mode. I had some problems seeing people from afar, especially since it was at 720p low settings. It was very blurry, but when we stepped up to 1080p on a blend of high settings and things turned off, we were getting 140 average FPS on this setup with our DDR4 XMP profiles at 3200 megahertz and the GTX 1070 that we had here. We decided to leave this on stock and not overclock it because I was having issues with the game. Even though I can overclock this card and get an extra 10% performance out of it, I decided to leave it off and even use Shadow Play while I was doing these benchmarks. So if you have Shadow Play off and you turn on the overclocks, you'll get over that 144 average sweet spot with these settings, which will make it a great combination for playing competitively and still getting a good visual experience. In terms of the Ryzen 5 1600AF, that CPU is incredible value for money at $85. The included cooler does a really good job out of the box, where in games we're seeing around 3.6 gigahertz all cores without overclocking. But as we said before, overclocking the CPU was a bit difficult on this included cooler. It's about 26 degrees ambience where I live, and so it does get a bit hot, but if you're in a cooler climate, you may wish to experiment trying to get a bit more out of this CPU, which it can definitely do. And with all that out of the way, if you guys are after a gaming PC for a little over 500 bucks, then this combination right here is one to think about. Well, we've even got the bling thrown in to match the whole build. So we've got aesthetics, we got performance, and we've also got a pretty good budget. I'll leave some links in the description below, but with that aside, do let us know in the comment section below what you think of Call of Duty Warzone and also what you think of this gaming PC. Love reading your thoughts and opinions as always. And speaking of it being hot, we've got the question of the day, which comes from Stuntman Ford. And they say, I don't want to be rude, I love your content and you're awesome, but I've always wondered why it looks like you're sweating in your videos. Sorry if that's rude. Lol, is it that hot there? Do you not have air conditioning? And so in some of my videos, I'm going to be honest, I do sweat in some of my videos. It does get pretty hot where I'm at in Queensland, especially us going through the summer where the rest of the world's pretty much going through the winter. If it gets that hot, I do turn on my aircon, but most of the time, even in like 28 degrees up to about 30 degrees, I do leave my aircon off just because I don't believe in wasting power. Just like with you guys watch the used builds, I don't believe in wasting used components too. So I hope that answers that question for you. If you guys enjoyed this video, then be sure to hit that like button for us. And if you've stayed this far and you're enjoying that content, then you know what to do, and I'll catch you in another tech video very soon. Peace out for now. Bye.